first of all, thank you very much for the invitation. Let me have a chance. I think for me, my first time to be sitting in front of so many graduate and high school students. So my pleasure to be here. Today, I think, you know, I really like to share our story, the world toward hard cloud charging battery. Okay, let's get started. So, we're not ready for the daily current life. In the audience, everyone must have this kind of smartphone or iPad and so on, this kind of desktop device. The very important is they must have one important one is the battery, including the microphone here or this kind of laser point here. So the battery is very important in our daily life. This is something the one see, only something maybe the modern technology. But in fact, yes, it's not true. In terms of development for battery, can go back to almost 200 years ago, developed by Professor Walter in Italy. In fact, why I call Professor? Because he's the first one to demonstrate Professor is useful. Because in your mind, the Professor something just give you, teach you knowledge. But Walter is the first one to invent the technology. The one never appeared before, and it come out some new perspective. So that's why, as a recognition, water is in this note. This I'm not sure how many people know this note. It's Italian lira. So this used long time, about 20 years ago, before you to be used in Italy. So in this one, you know, where's the battery? The battery, in fact, this one. This is the 200 years ago, exactly 1799, when what? First one invented this battery. So this is the first battery. See? This is a real picture how it looks like now in the museum. So for this battery device, it's very, very simple. They just put a metal in a tissue, the paper, and they have some sort of light. And then they can produce the electron. If there's a billion electrons come together, they go for a certain, this kind of current, and can use for a power device. So this is 200 years ago. Of course, now we can much today technology be much, much better than 20 years ago. Lithium-ion batteries is one of the common technology now used in our daily life. So for if we go for discuss about what is really lithium-ion battery, I use one picture to tell you it's very simple scheme. In the device itself, have this kind of lithium-ion migrate inside between the anode and the cathode materials. And then in outside circuit, exactly, we generate this kind of electron and to power your device. This exactly of this kind of device, this positive, this kind of negative. Okay, so this is the principle of this kind of lithium batteries. But the question is, for lithium batteries, like very, very few questions. First one, for example, for this kind of smartphone, everyone has to have it. I still remember in 2009, I get my first iPhone. And the question is, every day I get my iPhone, I went to office, the first job, I take my iPhone out of my pocket and connect with the charger. What's the reason? Because in late afternoon, if I charge it, in late afternoon, if my wife call me, I cannot receive the call because out of battery, and I will be in trouble in the evening. Okay, so this is the question, right? And another question, now of course, the great widespread is that because you want to charge the battery, it takes more than 1 hour for this kind of iPhone, about go back to 2009. And then of course, another question, there are two questions come up. First one, can you maybe make this kind of more capacity? For example, increase size of this kind of battery, make it bigger. Okay, it's more like, you know, maybe 20 years ago, this kind of huge mobile phone, right? Of course, no one will like it. The second technology we better will be how to decrease the charging time. For example, in few minutes, a cup of coffee time, then a lot of people can accept it. Okay, so this is the question it really drives us. In fact, even go through the last 5 to 10 years, still a lot of questions didn't really solve it. In fact, that's why this is today life. A lot of people, you must connect with charger like this dog now. Or you must bring another device is what's called a power bank, right? You can see this is a smartphone, another device always connected, and then bring to everywhere. Okay, so this is something that can't test it. So this is something really a question to us. Can we do something to solve problem? For me, in fact, my background is more chemistry training. When I was this kind of undergraduate study, And later, I still perform chemistry training until I joined MTU as a professor, as the material science. So this is good for me because I know chemistry and also I know materials. So that's why, let's go back on the fundamental of this slide question again. For this device, this is to tell you the magnesium. You cannot change the magnesium overall. It's lithium transport, okay? From anode, between anode and cathode. So that's why, now a question to us. Can we change the anode? Or can we change the cathode? This kind of electro materials. Then can improve the performance. Okay, now we get started. And then we choose very traditional method for this kind of nanomaterials, I call it cooking. Because this is very common use in our lab. What we saw is kind of hydrothermal autoclave. This kind of method to grow nanomaterials. Or in principle, like this one, rice cooker. Okay, so everyone must know this picture. Okay, in fact, in chemistry, very similar. We just put different chemicals in this kind of autoclave and then heat it. Heating means increase the increase pressure, like this kind of rice cooker. And then at the end, after one day, you open, you get your materials. So this is really common in our lab. And what do we do? Of course, we do it and we try to get the materials here, okay, like this example. But unfortunately, these materials are very easy to aggregate. It means this aggregate, then cannot disperse homogeneously. Then when you go for the lab, for this kind of battery assembly test, what do you find? The performance is not as good as expected. You need a long time charging, key performance, like usually people in already in the current status. Okay, so this is question, how can we get better device? The reason for these materials get aggregated because they're smaller, easy to aggregate, high surface area. Then what can we do more? It's really something really like here, because we always do a lot of this kind of field experiment. Okay, so like you know, the student doing the homework, feel depressing. Okay, this is like, so that's what the depression always not only go to the students, also go to professor like me. Okay, so you know, in fact, my students, you know, sometimes, you know, I can tell you, sometimes my students can see my face. If they see, I smile, or they will say, oh, professor, person is very happy today, and then we can discuss something else. If sometimes I live like this way, then my student will not come to see me. Why? He said, I'm not happy today because I feel depressed. Okay, like students. Okay, so this is very, very common to me all through my life sometimes. So the question is, how we can do better technology? Really something to solve the problem. This picture, I believe a lot of students may know, bus and MRT. Okay, and then you will see the price of the house is really depend on the location, how far you near to MRT, right? Why? Because MRT weight is much, much better in terms of transport of the people. But for bus, of course it's good, but the question is always a lot of people complain, it's not on time, traffic, and so other questions. So what's the difference between the two? Transport. MRT is much, much high efficient in the way to transport people compared with the bus. One is this kind of long, much more people can hold on, right? These long tube structures. This is from my understanding. The second one is also more chance to this kind of transport. Okay? For example, for this kind of bus, it's always stuck in this kind of door, but not happening in the MRT lab. So that's why these two questions, this is something inspiration. Can we get this kind of nanomaterials, have this kind of very wrong, like a little tube, it's called so-called nano tube structures. And in this case, the lithium ion can transport inside very rapidly, and then this way can help for charging. So this is something we do. And of course, I don't want to make the system complicated, otherwise my student complain to me again. Easy to say, difficult to do, right? They always say, well, easy to, just tell me to do this one, but we take a more and more, we can get a feel again. So now, we just tell, we don't make it easy simple. Do not go for change too much. We just do here, okay? We learn from here already, is that can we do this kind of nanotube structure, like this kind of MRT, and transport this ion? And then in that protocol, we just use this TL2 materials. This TL materials is very common use in our daily life. Now, like the people, especially for girls, if you go for the beach, you must coating one layer something on your skin, right? First level is sunscreen. So sunscreen is made by TiO2 materials. So with this nanomaterial, as this kind of long materials, to synthesize this kind of nanotube materials, as I showed here. And then, of course, which method? We know already coffee, right? When you go for coffee drinking, you always ask for sugar. You put sugar inside, also this kind of stirring, right? Why stirring? Make more homogeneous, make more fast reaction. In a similar case, in a chemical reaction, we can use this kind of stirring method. And then what we do is, we just combining the stirring method with my rice cooker together. So as you saw by here, I have my rice, this kind of rice cooker here, inside, outside, I put this one stirrer inside. And then I have a high pressure with the stirring, and then once it goes for solution, then you can get a samples, and so here, it's just kind of gel materials, and so here, okay? So this is the traditional method, it's easy for phase separation as here, okay? But this is the one, we just simple change one stirring method, we can this materials as homogeneous, gel-like materials. This sample, I have one more than 1 year already, it's still gel materials. Of course, we can even do other kind of recipe, I can make it even larger scale. This is from this kind of milk, okay? But also, I always tell my student, do remember, market is TiO2 materials, not milk. Do not drink it. Okay, so what we do is we use these kind of materials and then go for a battery fabrication and process, and then we can get, definitely we can get our device. This is the device we can get it out. This is the means in 2 minute charging, okay, this is kind of scientifically translated, 2 minute charging, in terms of cyclability, we can run it for 10,000 cycles here, keep the performance still very, very, very good. So what that means? If 10,000 cycles, 1 day one charging, is more than 20 years already. And then charging 2 minutes, we can reach 70% of capacity. And then this is the one we achieved now. Now this kind of battery, as you saw in this slide. And if you compare with the traditional battery materials, we are much better not only in the charging speed, we are also good in this kind of lifetime. As you know, for normally for battery, the lifetime is only about 2 years, but we are more than 10 times better than. Okay, so this is something we make it. By the way, we even can do some device. This is our project device in larger scale device. We can power what is about 40 LED lights now. This is something even more beyond. But I would say, all of this technology is invented, but we still have a lot of long way to go. Now we start still one company now, really want to scale this device, commercialize it. This is something we are doing. And then we hope this technology invented in Singapore, also developed in Singapore. This is something we are on the way. But I believe the future is still bright. I hope maybe some audience will join our journey to this direction. And then, of course, during this journey, you know, I see still a lot of this kind of story we can learn. But here, I can just give you, as a professor, I see this is something I can learn. First one, art is I, technology is we. So what does it mean? Art, for example, piano, right? You can play yourself. Or picture, one picture, you can draw yourself, no problem, right? This is one, like Da Vinci, he did. But for technology, this is something I call it scum. Art can form alone. But for technology development, it's another way. You can, no single hero. It's always it's a teamwork. Today I'm sitting here, not because only myself. It's really because of my team. And we work close together, have this kind of strong interaction. Okay? And also cooperation. Otherwise, the technology cannot be developed in my group. Of course, now you know, when I go for speed on company, there's a lot of interaction not only with the research, also with entrepreneur, and also with this kind of business plan. So that's why technology development is still a long way to go. And then it's very, 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 very difficult and challenging, not so easy like business. But whatever, I think this is really the part of team we are doing together, and then this is really beyond the effort. Okay, thank you very much.